गुड मॉर्निंग स्टैंडर्ड 5 स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल स्टार्ट द फंक्शन ऑफ स्केलेटल सिस्टम एंड द अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द स्केलेटन। लेट अस स्टार्ट द फंक्शन ऑफ स्केलेटल सिस्टम। द फंक्शन ऑफ ह्यूमन स्केलेटन। ह्यूमन स्केलेटन हैज मेनी फंक्शंस, सो फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द फंक्शन। द स्केलेटन हैज द फॉलोइंग फंक्शंस। इट प्रोवाइड्स शेप्स एंड सपोर्ट टू योर बॉडी। विदाउट द स्केलेटन सिस्टम आवर बॉडी वुड बी फ्लॉपी लाइक ए जेली। We would not be able to stand also. Okay, so our skeleton system gives the shape and support. Without the skeleton, we cannot get any support and any shape of our body. We will be like a jelly of muscles. It protects our soft internal organs. So the skeleton protects the soft internal organs, like our skull protects the brain, the rib cage protects the heart and lungs. The backbone protects the spinal cord and the eyeball rests inside the bony eye socket in the skull. Number 3 is it allows the movement of different body parts. You know that our skeleton has attached muscles. With the help of attached muscles, they help us in the movement of the different body parts. Number 4, bone contains bone marrow where our blood cells are made. Inside the hollow of the bone, you know, the spongy tissue is present, that is called bone marrow, and that bone marrow produces the blood, new blood cells in our body. So it is also a very important part for producing new blood cells in our body. Now we will discuss about the joints and ligaments. So first we will know what are joints. The places where two or more bones meet or join together are called joints. So you know that in many places of our bone, you can see your finger also. You can fold your finger because there are many joints in our finger. In your hand also you can see. You can fold our hand because there is a joint. So the places where two bones meet together, these places are known as joints. So what are ligaments now? The bones are held together at the joints by strong tissues called ligaments. Two bones are joining together in these places. Ligaments are there. These ligaments make the places of the joint very strong so that it cannot easily be detached from each other. So ligaments are strong, but they can let your bones move. These are very strong tissue that joins the bones with the other bone. Now type of joints. There are mainly two kinds of joints in our body: immovable joints and movable joints. So from the name you can understand that joints simply connect the bones. The immovable joints only connect the bones. They do not allow the movement of the bones. In these places you cannot move your bones. These are found in the bones of the skull and pelvis. You know, our skull, the only movable joint in our skull is lower jaw bone. Now the only movable bone in the skull is lower jaw bone. It is also known as mandible. The other bones are immovable in the skull. Now movable joints. These joints allow full movement of the bones. The bones at the joints move smoothly because a fluid which acts as a lubricant known as synovial fluid is filled there. Okay, the spaces between the joints are filled with synovial fluid. That's why it allows the free movement of the body, and these joints are known as movable joints. Let us see about the synovial joint. You can see here the joint cavity, the two places where the place where you can see there is a hollow space where the fluid is filled. That fluid is known as synovial fluid, and it is given here now in this space between the two bones where the joints are there. So it is filled with synovial fluid that makes it lubricate so that the bones can move smoothly. Now movable joints we will discuss. So most joints in our body are movable. There are four kinds of movable joints. We will discuss one by one. First we will discuss about the ball and socket joint. This type of joint allows movement in many directions. The shoulder joint and the hip joint are examples of ball and socket joint. In this type of joint, one part of the bone is like ball and the other part is like a socket. So the bone is ball is fixing inside the socket of the other bone, and it makes the free movement and the body can move in many direction. You can see the picture also, ball and socket joint. Like a ball, the place is, you can see here, one of the bone is like a ball, the head of the bone is like a ball, and the other is like a socket, and it fixes into the socket of the, you can see here it is shown, no? That is shoulder bone. You can see how it is fixing to the bone. So it is shoulder and hip joints, they have ball and socket like arrangement and they are multi-axial, that means they can move in many directions. You can see the another picture also, it is showing very nicely here. Now hinge joint, you have seen the hinges of the door, no? Window also. So it works like a hinges of the door. This type of joint allows back and forth movement. Bones in the knee, elbow, fingers and toes have this type of joint. Okay, in this what happened, it can move the bone only in one direction. Like your elbow, you can move in only one direction. You can move your elbow in only one direction. Knee is also the largest hinge joint and you can move your knee also in one direction only. You can see bones of the elbow, here it is shown very nicely how it is joined. This is the lateral outside view of the major bone, structure of the right elbow. Okay, here you can see how it is joined and it is a hinge joint. In this only you can move one direction, you cannot pull your elbow backside. Next is the human knee. In the knee also you can see there is hinge joint, you can pull your knee also in one direction only. Now next is pivot joint. Pivot joint is also known as rotary joint. Okay, this type of joint is found between the skull and the first two vertebrae of the spine. It is joined to the spine. It allows you to move your head up and down and sideways. Now we can move our head up and down and sideways also, right and left. This moving bone rotates within a ring that is formed from a second bone and the adjoining ligament. Ligament is there in every joint, you know. So you can see examples of pivot joint: elbow between the radius and humerus, the neck between the atlas C1 and axis 2, that means first two vertebrae of the head is fixed into the first. You can see in the picture also the head is fixed into the two vertebrae, first and second vertebrae. This joint is known as pivot joint. Now next joint is gliding joint. Gliding joint, this joint allows the bones to glide past one another. They are gliding over each other in any direction along the plane of the joint where they are joining, in that they are gliding against each other. Some of the bones in your wrist and ankles move by gliding against each other. You can bend your back easily because of this joint. In the back also 33 small bones are joined by this each other with the gliding joint. You can see the picture also, gliding joint, your wrist and ankle, they have gliding joint. The bones in the wrist and ankle, they glide over each other. You can see in your ankle also, it is also gliding joint, they are gliding over each other. Gliding joint, wrist bones, you can see here the picture shown here how it is gliding here. So it is also gliding joint in your wrist bones. Now some facts are there. Giraffe's neck, which can be as long as 6 feet, you know, giraffe leg is so long. Humans and giraffes have the same number of bones. You will be surprised to know that giraffe neck is so much long, but still they have the same number of bones in their neck as humans. But giraffe's neck vertebrae are so much longer. Now they are much, much longer than our human vertebrae. That's why their neck is longer. Now femur is the longest bone in your body. Femur is the longest bone in your body. Sartorius is the longest muscle in the human body. And your big toes have 2 bones each, whereas the other toes have 3 bones each. In your fingers also same thing, all your fingers have 3 bones and your thumb has 2 bones like your big toe. Now next we will discuss about the muscular system. The muscular system is composed of special cells called muscle fibers. Now they are fibers. It includes the different types of muscles in the body. We don't have the same type of muscle all over the body. We have different types of muscles. Nearly all the movement in the body is the result of muscle contraction and relaxation. Muscles are contracting and relaxing to give us the movement of the different body parts. So we will see about the muscles. Our skeletal system is covered with muscle. You cannot see any of the bone of your skeletal system, because all the skeletal system is covered with muscle. So there are more than 600 muscles, nearly 640 muscles are there in our body. What are muscles are made up of? Muscles are made up of long, strong fibers. It is very strong. It is not easily pulled out. No, muscles are the muscular system is responsible for the movement of the human body. Without the muscle, movement of the body is not possible because only the muscle contracts and relaxes, and the our body moves. Muscles are tough, elastic, fleshy, and strong tissues in our body. Some muscles are attached to the bones. These muscles pull the bones and help in movements. How do muscles help the movement? They pull the bones and they help in the movement by pulling the bones. And they are attached to the bones with the help of a special tissue, a strong tissue called tendons. The muscles help us to walk and jump. The arm muscles used to lift the things. The face muscles help us to smile and frown. And the eye muscles help to blink and wink our eyes. Muscles which are not attached to the bones do things like pushing food like our alimentary canal, pumping the blood like our heart. So they are not attached to the skeleton, but they do our internal functions like our heart, our alimentary canal, etc. Our kidney, our lungs. How do muscles work? Muscles work in pairs. Now, always muscles are working in pair. That means if one muscle contracts, the other muscle relaxes. Muscles are attached to the bones by tendons and help them to move. Without the tendon, muscles will not be able to move and it will not be attached to the bone. When a muscle contracts, bunches up, it gets shorter. When muscle contract, it becomes shorter and it gets shorter, so pulls on the bone. When it becomes shorter, then it pulls the bone. It is attached too. When a muscle relaxes, it goes back to its normal size. Again, the muscle relaxes. Then again comes back to its normal size. Muscles can only pull and cannot push. This is very important fact that muscle can pull only the bones. They cannot push the bones. Therefore, muscles have to work in pairs to move a joint. One muscle will contract and pull a joint one way and the another muscle will contract and pull it in the other. Okay? So, this is working in pair. Muscles are working in pair. You can see in this picture also it is showing how muscles work. Now, working in pairs. Muscles can pull but not push. They work in pairs that pull in opposite directions. When one muscle pulls, it partner relaxes. Now, if one is contracting, the partner is relaxing. Like this, the muscle helps us in movement. Types of muscles, now we will see. There are three types of muscle: cardiac muscle, skeletal muscles, and smooth muscles. You can see the body parts is also shown here, cardiac muscle. Cardiac muscles are present in our heart only. Skeletal muscles, they are also known as voluntary muscle because they work at our will. Smooth muscles, they are involuntary muscles, they are not attached to the bone, that's why they are also known as smooth muscles, and they work without our will, they are not under our control. Now we will discuss individually with which about each of the muscles. Voluntary muscles first we will discuss. These type of muscles are attached either directly or indirectly to the bones. That means they are skeletal muscles. These muscles can be controlled and work at our will. These are found in our arms, legs, eyes, tongue. We can move our tongue, our arms and legs according to our wish. Thus, while reading, writing, walking or running, we use voluntary muscles. They are also known as skeletal muscles because they are attached to the skeleton. Now, involuntary muscles. These muscles are not under our control. That's why they are known as involuntary muscles. These muscles are found in the internal body organs and works automatically. We cannot control the movement, the actions of these muscles. The control actions like the movement of food in the alimentary canal, the flow of blood and the movement of eye muscles. In the movement of food in the alimentary canal we cannot control. Pumping of the blood also we cannot control. We cannot control the function of the kidney also, that is filtering blood. They are also known as smooth muscles because they are not connected with any of the bone, any of the skeleton. Now, next is cardiac muscle. These muscles are found in the heart, but they are involuntary muscles responsible for pumping the blood. They are involuntary in their action, but there is special type of cells. They are present only in the heart. That's why they are known as cardiac muscles. So they are responsible for pumping the blood. You know, now our heart pumps the blood all over the body. You can see the cardiac muscles. They are very special muscles and present only in the heart. You can see here the muscles of the heart. So this much only in this class, students. Thank you all of you. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.